New camera, and how do I look? Really blown out now. Guess I'm gonna have to invest in some softer lighting. But hey, now it's true 1080-60 camera. Today's episode is brought to you through the combined efforts of people who hate me for some reason. Link in the description. Having no idea when the game actually began development, IdleFX and Majesco plan to launch a brand new media mascot empire in 2003, spanning a series of games, comics, and an animated television series. That obviously didn't happen. Touted as being the second worst game on the OG Xbox, coming behind Aquaman cocksucking for Alan Rickman, Drake hit the streets like a 40-ton sack of shit. But was it deserving of its hate? Is it really all that bad? This is Drake and the 99 Joshes. Yes, there's absolutely nothing redeeming about this game. It's an entirely broken bucket of fuck. Unfortunately, it's not a spectacle of jank a la Alpha Protocol, nor is it a complete mess like Cyberpunk. 9 out of 10 things, including Drake's powers, simply don't work. Or at least do not work in any way that I can guarantee are functioning as intended or not. You see, this game is played on PC, and the PC version is notoriously jank to the point that the only way to gain any more insight as to what's functioning as intended or not is to play it on the OG Xbox as well, and I'm not doing that. The one thing that I do know is functioning as intended is the slow time ability. You see, this game was made in the Matrix area. 'Twas a mystical time where everything was trench coats, shitty low energy techno, and slow motion. Think Max Payne, Fear, Blood Rain, porn, hamburgers, etc. Yes, Drake can slow time. Yes, Drake has to slow time, because if you're not constantly slowing time, you're constantly soaking up damage and instantly dying, and I do mean instantly. You go from full health to dead in the span of time it takes for the door to open, or in the case of some levels, immediately after spawning in. So the entirety of the game is played in a single frame at a time, meaning under my best assumption of the game, it is intentionally designed to be played as slowly and tediously as possible. Moving very slowly. Platforming is god-awful. Drake can wall run and wall jump, and he randomly sticks to things or launches himself off of them, depending on whichever whim takes him at the time. It doesn't feel good. It never feels good. It takes far too long to get the hang of, and even when you do, you're constantly fighting against Drake. He can't walk down slopes. It's the Dark Souls 2 issue, where changes in elevation don't count as a slope, they count as a drop, and the game launches Drake over that tiny edge with far momentum than anything the player can generate by themselves, which means walking downstairs launches your ass into orbit. Graphic design, aesthetic, all of that shit, it's bland. I will have forgotten everything about it a week from now. It's not ugly, it's just vanilla. Soundtrack is non-existent. The game isn't good on any level, no pun intended, but it's also not bad enough to have a point to remembering it. I'm a huge supporter of games preservation, but there reaches a point where you are actively forcing yourself to hold on to a boring, tedious, and completely unremarkable experience for no other reason than preserving the negative feelings associated with it. And that's the kind of thing courts order you into therapy for, lest you do a nickel. Get help! It's garbage, it's not good garbage, and it's not catastrophic garbage. It's wee shovelware garbage. I will have no recollection of my experience with it a week from now, neither would you, and any attempt to preserve the memory of this game comes entirely at the detriment of preserving games that actually deserve it. You know how broken it is. Other people have cataloged it extensively. There's just nothing there. Hell, if this game didn't turn out exactly the way they intended it to, I couldn't find any information in regards to that. Did I look very hard? No. Do I care to? Also no. Does it make any difference? For a third time, no. Nothing in the game is offensive, it just simply doesn't work, and what does work has to be played in the most mind-numbing manner possible. Nothing is going to stick with you a handful of days after you put it down, and it will never be worth the effort to talk about. Some sick portion of your man-mayonnaise-drenched frontal cortex can appreciate what they were going for in the era it was created, but the only thing the game deserves is exactly what it earns. To be forgotten. Man, I really hate nothing games. I have nothing to say about them, no fun jokes, no great disdain to express, and the end result is we get 3 entire minutes dedicated to talking about the game. Fucking sucks. Fuck. Now what? Death montage? Death montage. Hit it! Oh shit, it's still fucking going. God damn. That's a lot. Do you think we ever hit the Drake and the 99 deaths mark? he's so fat. Just look at it go. God damn. So how's your week been going? Getting ready for that there Memorial Day weekend? Gonna go out and barbecue with the family and toss the cricket ball back and forth at the hockey rink with the kids? Oh, thank God it's coming to an end finally. I'm the NecroSwanson, and you can go fuck yourselves!